great. Here we go.
So right here is Starkiller again, diving for freedom. He's just escaped Darth Vader. He's already on the run here, and this is one of what we call our run for your life moments in the game. There'll be several throughout the game that really establish the fact that, you know, Starkiller is a fugitive. We're building this on the same engine that we use for Force Unleashed 1, although we've upgraded it quite significantly. We focused on, you know, changes to lighting and to the VFX, the number of units we can have on screen. But again, we're combining three very unique technologies in order to simulate a really interactive environment. So we have Havoc as our underlying physics system. We have digital molecular matter, which allows us to do things like shattering glass. And then we have Euphoria, which is biomechanical AI.
And lets you fling the stormtroopers like we just saw there?
Exactly right. They're, you know, much more than ragdolls. It's pretty fantastic. So here you can see Starkiller with now his trademark dual-wield lightsabers.
There they are.
Again, all the force powers are back again. So lightning and force push and force grip, force throw. We've redesigned all the force powers from the ground up, though, to make them a little bit more accessible and make them more tactically significant in combat. And we did the same with the AI. So this is one of our new units, our Imperial Melee unit. Mm-hmm. And you actually will be encouraged to use force powers against him. He's very resistant to your lightsaber. And there you can see force gripping.
There's
used to take a TIE
right
fighter right out of the sky. Yeah.
Compacted it.
That's right.
That looks satisfying.
With force gripping. So here's a much larger battle with, again, these Imperial Riot troops with their melee weapons that will encourage you to use force powers or lightsaber and force power combos, and then a number of stormtroopers. So, you know, kind of picking how you attack the different enemies will be very important in Force Unleashed too.
Now, I couldn't help but just notice that these stormtroopers are losing limbs.
They are. So that's one of the other upgrades to Force Unleashed 2 is we really wanted to focus on how do we make the lightsaber feel more like a lightsaber. We've always treated it as another one of your powers in the Force Unleashed. It's just as important as lightning and force grip or force repulse. But we wanted to enhance it even more. So again, redesigned the combo system from the ground up to take advantage of the dual wield, but have also added some effects like that decapitation and the delimbing to make it feel more like a lightsaber.
Always a good time when you can take off some limbs.
Yeah, exactly. And you know, very true to the films, but again, a little bit over the top, a little re-envisioned.
Sure.
One of the other things we focused really heavily on was the pacing of the game. So Force Unleashed 1 was all kind of one note, this over-the-top action, which, you know, if you're going to pick one note, I feel like we picked the right one note, but we wanted to add a few more for Force Unleashed 2. So a little bit more exploration, some more using your force powers for solving not only tactical puzzles, but navigation puzzles as well. Mm-hmm. And we think that'll just mix up gameplay a little bit more and allow you an opportunity to really take in the kind of gorgeous environments that we have going here.
Sure. Could you give us first off, I saw this in the demo. Tell us what's happening to those guys.
So this is Jedi Mind Trick in action. So Jedi Mind Trick is a brand new power that, again, we wanted to re-envision and make feel unleashed. So Jedi Mind Trick does a couple different things. First off, it turns allies or enemies into allies, and they'll literally attack their own allies. And then it will also cause some weak-willed enemies like those Imperial Riot Troops or Stormtroopers to jump off cliffs. So, you know, comedy is a big part of Star Wars, and we wanted to make sure that it was part of the game as well.
To decide that diving to their doom is the
That's
best.
That's right, yeah.
And speaking of comedy, did I just see someone, a jetpack trooper, go squirreling off into the distance?
That's right. So, you know, we had about 100 enemies in Force Unleashed 1, and as a result, some of them felt kind of generic or vanilla. We've gone down to about 25 enemies, but they're all handcrafted to be very tactically significant. And the jump trooper is one that we brought back from Force Unleashed 1, but we've completely re-envisioned in a lot of ways and redesigned. We've added that susceptibility to lightning, which was there in the first game, but we've really, again, amped it up and made it a more significant part of fighting those guys.
Amped it up, I like that phrase. Now, it looks like tactical significance is coming into play here.
Yeah.
What just happened?
So this is our Carbonite War Droid. He's a new unit in Force Unleashed 2 that's designed to really encourage you to use your range powers and keep your distance from him. He's got a shield that allows him to resist various force powers and some of your lightsaber attacks.
Well, he doesn't have it anymore.
Well, right, because you use force grip to rip it off and then damage him. And now we can actually go in and start using lightsaber throw and lightning to start doing damage to him. But you're still going to want to keep your distance because ultimately, if you get too close, he can freeze you with that carbonite gun of his shatter you. Yeah. And that's actually exactly what happened.
There we go. So, we got a great temp.
Casino planet. So imagine all the destruction of a giant, you know, Imperial casino on this kind of archway planet.
Which begs the question, can you use force powers to trigger a jackpot?
Well, it's funny you ask. We actually have something like that in the game as a reward for, you know, destroying things in the environment. We really want to encourage you to use the environment to your advantage. as much as possible. And we do that even here in these environments where you can see things like turbines in the background, and those things can actually be used to take out enemies, and you'll get rewarded for doing that in the form of experience points.
Excellent. And now we just saw the enemy get the bad end of the carbon knight
stick.
That's
right, yeah, which is one of our finishing moves in the game. So here we're about to show you another one of these run for your life moments. We're really trying to emphasize the fact that Starkiller is a fugitive on the run from Darth Vader, trying to find his love interest, Juno Eclipse. And throughout the game, you'll have these moments where you literally have to run for your life. And we get to capture all the glory of the destruction and the power of our engine.
Sure, and now when you say run for your life, it's not just running. It's force dashing, it's jumping, you have to use your powers to get yourself to safety.
Exactly, right. So what we saw there was a ton of jumping and force push, force dash, and later levels you'll need to fight enemies along the way as well. They'll get into your path. So, and it, again, really emphasizes that fact that he's a fugitive and then amps up the intensity for a period of time, which goes back to that point of pacing the game.
Uh-huh.
So here we're using force grip to take down an Imperial gunship.
Ooh.
And actually use it to create a bridge to move from one end of Kamino to the other. And
how terribly convenient.
Exactly.
And
so
I noticed while he was shaking that around, stormtroopers went flying out of it.
Exactly. And we're, so adding a little bit of comedy to a game that truly has a very dark story was
sure.
Important to us. You know, that we feel that's part of Star Wars.
I think that's part of what I loved about Force Unleashed is it's the gleeful use of the powers.
Yeah. No, it's great. It's, you know, you feel like sometimes you're just, you know, trying to figure out how it is that you want to take down a group of stormtroopers. So here we're showcasing Force Fury, which is another new feature of the Force Unleashed 2. Basically, over time, you'll build up your Force Fury meter and be able to unleash it and take all of your powers well beyond anything you can rank them up to in game. So Force Grip can be used to take down AT-STs. A Force Push can be used to take out an entire group of stormtroopers and literally send them into orbit. I mean, that was just a tap of Force Push there. And then I think my favorite thing is what happens when you use your lightsaber. So here we're going to wade into this battle with these stormtroopers, and you see all your lightsaber combos now become ranged combos. So again, these are doing the same combos you've learned throughout the game, but they all become ranged combos that literally will take out entire groups of stormtroopers.
And now he's flinging those lightsabers around like crazy.
Exactly, yeah. So then this is a brief glimpse at a cinematic in the game. So again, we're telling a very epic story. It's also very personal to Starkiller, his journey to find out who he is and to be reunited with Juno Eclipse and the rest of the Rebel Alliance.
Sure. And in this scene, get the hell away from Lord Vader.
That's right. So and we have a little nod to Empire Strikes Back here that I think fans will pick up on.
Yep.
For us, we really feel like in many ways this is our Empire Strikes Back. It's a little bit darker than the first game. In some ways, it's continuing the trilogy. It's a more personal story,
uh-huh.
Very character-driven. So, you know, we wanted to get